السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله سبحانه وتعالى بحبيبه الأمة وجاهد صلى الله عليه وسلم في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وإن خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise and thanks are due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the most gracious, the most merciful. He subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, provided for us, did not leave us without a purpose, but he sent us Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and whoever obeys him will go to Jannah, and whoever disobeys him will go to Nar. Peace and the blessings upon Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family, his household, his companions, And all Muslims who follow him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the true path of Islam until the day of judgment. Ameen. The best of the speech is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kalamullah, Al-Quran. The best of guidance is the guidance of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The worst of all matters are innovations in the deen of Islam. Any innovation in the deen of Islam leads to misguidance, and every misguidance leads to the hellfire. We seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from any innovation in the deen, from any misguidance, and from the hellfire. Ameen, ameen. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We praise Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and thank Him day and night for being Muslims and Mu'mins. And we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala that we don't leave this life until He subhanahu wa ta'ala writes us with the muhsins, the good doers, the ones who worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala as if they see Him, and if they don't see Him, He subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing them. Ameen, ameen. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is blessing the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every short time, He subhanahu wa ta'ala gets us a season of ibadah, a season of virtues, a season of rahmah, a season of maghfirah. And weeks ago, we were talking about Ramadan, preparing for Ramadan. Now, Ramadan has come. Most likely tonight will be the first night of the month of Ramadan. And we said we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to extend our lives to witness that blessed month. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the strength and to give us the righteousness to stay in salah and qiyam and qira'at al-Quran during that month. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us the good deeds we do, and we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala that this month of Ramadan that's coming does not leave us until our sins are forgiven and our a'mal are accepted, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with us and we are pleased with Him. Ameen, ameen, ameen. So these seasons of ibadat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends us from time to time a season of ibadah, a time that He subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives within, a time that He subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming to us, asking us to come closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, He is the Lord, He is the Creator, but He subhanahu wa ta'ala comes close to those mu'mins and muhsins and righteous people who want to come closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we as Muslims should follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions. They were competing in the khayr. They were competing and hastening to the virtues and the good deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He commands us, وَفِي ذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. And in this virtue, this khayr, this rahmah, the ones who want to compete, they should compete in this. This is the time for competition, the real competition, the competition that we all are seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the competition that each and every one of us wants his sins to be forgiven, the competition during which all of us are looking for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Jannah, and the competition within which that we are looking to accompany Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah al-Firdaus, inshaAllah. This is the right time. This is the time that we should compete. This is the time that we should sacrifice. This is the time that we should leave our time in our families, in our jobs, and we should dedicate more and more towards our Akhirah, towards our last day, towards the day that nothing will benefit us except a good heart and a good deed that we do in this dunya before we leave that dunya and go to the Akhirah. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the hadith that Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu narrates that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اِفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ دَهْرَكُمْ وَتَعَرَّضُوا لِنَفَحَاتِ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّ لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ نَفَحَاتٍ مِّنْ رَحْمَتِهِ يُصِيبُ بِهَا مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَسَلُوا اللَّهَ أَنْ يَسْتُرَ عَوْرَاتِكُمْ وَأَنْ يُؤَمِّنَ رَوْعَاتِكُمْ. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this hadith is explaining to us the importance of the time which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed to us. He subhanahu wa ta'ala through the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, do the good deeds, do the virtue. During these days, all over the year, and there are specific times that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends more rahmah to earth. So you should be there when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends His rahmah. And this rahmah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives it to whomever He wills subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should be from those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and He bestows His rahmah upon. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ends the hadith saying, وَسَلُوا اللَّهَ أَنْ يَسْتُرَ عَوَرَاتِكُمْ. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cover your sins. وَأَنْ يُؤَمِّنَ رَوْعَاتِكُمْ. That he subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you safe and secure wherever you stay. This is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam giving me and you an advice. These days are blessed days. Days of rahmah, days of maghfirah. So we should be eligible for the rahmatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should be ready for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rahmat. And these days are starting tonight by the first night of the month of Ramadan. And also, when Ramadan comes to us, we are ready. We should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by reaching that month. We said the Sahaba and the Salaf ridwanullahi alayhim will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 6 months before Ramadan to reach that month. Once Ramadan comes, they do what they have to do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept the deed. So we should be happy. We should thank Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the ni'am. Al-Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah will say, any blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving to you, any harm that He subhanahu wa ta'ala is preventing you from, you should bow and prostrate, thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this. Look, tonight or tomorrow night, when we stand together in Salatul Taraweeh, how many people last year were present with us, praying Taraweeh with us, but this year they are not there. And if they are giving a wish by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will wish to come back and spend 1 day, 1 hour in the month of Ramadan. Consider yourself this man or this woman who left and is wishing to come back, and Ramadan is coming back. This is the time we should take it and take the opportunity and use it the way it should be. So we should be happy when Ramadan comes. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to give the good news to the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim. When he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cites the crescent moon for the month of Ramadan, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will talk to Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim, and he will say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أتاكم شهر رمضان شهر مبارك كتب الله عليكم صيامه فيه تفتح أبواب الجنة وتغلق أبواب النار وتصفر الشياطين فيه ليلة خير من ألف شهر من حرمها حرم الخير أو من حرمها فقد حرم. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by the last days of Sha'ban, the beginning of Ramadan, he will give the glad tidings to the Sahaba, the good news, Ramadan is coming tomorrow and after tomorrow. This is a blessed month. This is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the gates of Jannah. All of them are wide open. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala closes the gates of the fire of hell. All of them are closed. And all the devils are chained during that month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made siyam as an obligation for you. During that month, there is one night that is better than 1,000 months. Whoever is prevented the khair of that night, he is really prevented from rahmatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is motivating the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim. He is putting this enthusiasm in their hearts radiallahu anhum to accept and to come and welcome that month of Ramadan, to be ready for ibadatullah, to be ready for the Quran, to be ready for the Taraweeh, to be ready for the sadaqat, to be ready to be generous, to be ready for helping others, to be ready to change all your daily life and to be upside down the other way. If Ramadan comes and we do not change, we will never change. Ramadan is a time for a change for each and every Muslim and Muslimah. We should change our life during that month. We should show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the best of ourselves, because He subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the best of the month, during which He subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the best of the books to the best of the prophets, sending all this to the best of the nations. These ni'am require thanking Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and praising Him subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night, and submitting ourselves to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Ramadan comes, he enthusiasm, he motivates, he generates this love of ibadah in the hearts of the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhi. And also we should have the intention, the good intention, the true intention, that inshallah this month is coming and inshallah I'm going to use it the best way I can. Make a covenant, make a promise with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will not let this month go without my sins being forgiven inshallah. Be truthful with Allah, He subhanahu wa ta'ala will be truthful with you. This is His way subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember the Sahabi who just accepted the Shahada in one of the battles with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was a mushrik, he was a kafir. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is about to start the battle, and this man came and accepted Islam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened his chest to Islam, and he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. And he's asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Prophet of Allah, if I go to the battle and I get an arrow from my neck here and it goes out from here and I die in the way of Allah, am I going to Jannah? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, yes, you are going to Jannah. He didn't do anything in his life. He just took the Shahada minutes ago and he took his sword and he started fighting in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the end of the battles, the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim found him among the martyrs, among the dead. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked about him, it was told to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we found him getting an arrow from his neck, the right side is getting out from the left side. The way that he explained to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam before the battle, if I get an arrow from here, that gets out from here, and I die in the way of Allah today, am I going to Jannah? The Prophet said, yes, and he did. And he fight in the way of Allah, and he dies without doing anything good in his life. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when seeing this, said, صَدَقَ اللَّهَ فَصَدَقَهُ اللَّهُ. He was truthful with Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be truthful with him. He was truthful in his La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, fighting for the way of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be truthful with him and will return to him as a martyr, as a shaheed, and he will go to Jannah, although he didn't do anything before that and he wasn't even a Muslim. So when Ramadan comes, we need that determination. Insha'Allah, Ramadan is coming. I am not going to leave it go by until I get my sins forgiven from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, one of the great issues that we have to talk about by the coming of Ramadan is tawbah, repentance. We should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling upon the believers, oh, you believe, submit yourselves in tawbah, repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you may be successful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love those who come to Him in repentance and those who purify themselves. The Muslim is always coming to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in tawbah. The Muslim is always clean and purifying himself for salah and even outside the salah. And also, by Ramadan coming, we should open a new page with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever we have done during that last year, we should turn the page, start from the beginning of the page, with asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tawbah, maghfirah, rahmah, and asking Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. We turn the page with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by following Him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is Ramadan coming. I did not follow Him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the way it should be. Inshallah, from today, I am starting a new page with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm starting a new page with my family, my wife, my children. I wasn't good to them. Inshallah, from today, I'll be good. and be the ideal Muslim in his way, dealing with his wife and children. I am opening a new page with the community I'm living with. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ أَنْفَعُهُمْ لِلنَّاسِ. The best of the people is the one who benefits them most. Look around you, can you benefit your community? Muslims and non-Muslims. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was rahmah to all humans, Muslims and kafirs. So we should be the same. Living in here, in a non-Muslim atmosphere, we should be forgiving, loving to Muslims and non-Muslims. And this is from the core and crux principles of our way as Muslims. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور. الحمد لله رب العالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ولي الصالحين. أشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله وبعد. So the month of Ramadan has come to us. Are we ready for that month or not? This is a question that does not need an answer by our mouth. It needs an answer by our actions. Ramadan is starting inshallah tonight, most likely. Salat al-Tarawih will be there. Qira'at al-Quran will be there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be more than ready to forgive and accept and turn the page with all of us if we are ready. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. If my servants ask you Muhammad about me, say I'm near from them. I answer the call if the caller, if he or she asks me. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Sahih Hadith also tells us, when the first night of Ramadan comes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the gates of Jannah, none of them will be closed, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala will close all the gates of the fire, none of them will be opened, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala will chain the shayateen, and none of them will be out, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala will send a caller to call, Ya Baghi al-Khayri Aqbil. Oh, the one who wants good, come in, come forward. Ya Baghi al-Shari Aqsir. Who wants evil, go back. This is not the time of evil. Ramadan is the time of goodness. Ramadan is the time of forgiveness. Ramadan is the month of the Quran during which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the book of the Quran. And then Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not just send the Quran in Ramadan, but He subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the sheets of Ibrahim to Ibrahim the first day of Ramadan. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the sheets of Musa or the Torah to Musa in the sixth day of Ramadan. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Injil to Isa after 13 days of Ramadan. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Quran to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after 24 days of Ramadan. All the sacred books came from heaven, came during that month of Ramadan. Are we ready for the rahmatullah? Are we ready for the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are we ready to forgive our neighbors, our family members, our relatives, for whatever they have done to us? And say, we are sorry, we forgive you. If we are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be forgiven, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala will be putting us in the way to Jannah through that month. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala will elevate our ranks. And as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ends that hadith saying, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of Ramadan, that He subhanahu wa ta'ala sets people free from the fire every day, starting the first day of Ramadan. We should be waiting for this, to set our necks free from the fire, to go to that door of Jannah, to be behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, those Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum, to be away from those evil people around us who take us away from the ibadat in Ramadan, who want us to go outside for the coffee shops and to watch movies. This is not the time for Ramadan. Ramadan is the time of ibadatullah. Ramadan is the time to come close from Allah. Ramadan is our time to show Allah the best of ourselves. Should we do it? If we do it, He subhanahu wa ta'ala is ready for forgiveness. If we do not do it, we will be prevented from His rahmah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to do good deeds during that month of Ramadan. I ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our good deeds during that month of Ramadan. I ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to understand and read the Quran in the month of Ramadan. I ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to open the gates for us to go through the gates of Jannah with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during that month of Ramadan. I ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins, to accept our deeds, to accept our ibadat, to protect us from the shaitan, to protect us from our desires and temptations. Allahumma aghfir lana ma qaddamna wa ma akharna, ma asrarna wa ma a'lanna, ma anta a'lamu bihi minna, anta al-muqaddim wa anta al-muakhir, innaka ala kulli shay'in qadir, ibadallah, inna Allah ya'muru bil 'adli wal ihsan, ita'i dhil qurba, yanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar wal baghy, ya'idhukum la'allakum tadhakkarun, fadhkuru Allah al-'azhim yadhkurkum, wa ashkuruhu 'ala ni'amihi yazidkum, wa la dhikru Allah ajall wa akbar, wa Allah ya'lamu ma tasna'un, wa aqimu as-salah.
Okay.